Hi everyone, hope that you are well. Today I want to discuss about how you can create lighting scenes and as well how you can group luminaires. Yeah, let's say you have one, two, three different luminaires which are using for one space, and then you want to create a different light scenes for each, for example, luminaire or type of lighting feature. You will use a different lighting scene, which can be dimmed, can be switched off, or can have a different, let's say, switching time. And yeah, it give you more flexible, and as well, yeah, you can have a better overview. What does it mean when the whole lighting is on 50%, 60, or whatever percent you wish to have. So I will start with the following layout. Here we have already a lighting solution or lighting design for an amphitheater. If you did not visualize the video, I will let the link to this video on the description. So if you did not as well subscribe to my channel, please subscribe to my channel, please give a like to this video. It will help with the algorithm for my YouTube channel. So let's start creating the lighting scenes. First, you need to go on the light fixtures, and then you'll go on the light scenes, click on the button. So you see here we have already the general lighting, and this means on the light scene number one we have a 24 luminaires. So in total we have 24 luminaires. I want to add, let's say, an addition two lighting scenes and also group the luminaire. For example, I want a light scenes where I have only the front row, which I want to control, let's say, separate from the rest, and we can have, in addition, I will say a different lighting scenes, let's say one first and the second row, just as an example, and we want to have it dim, let's say, to 50%. One important aspect, you can see it also here, the light output. For example, now it's 100% by, yeah, you can do it like this by the scroll, or you just plus and minus. You can do as well. Here it's a very good note. If the luminaires which you are using for the lighting design don't have the property to be dimmed, then you'll have the exclamation mark and in this orange circle included. This is just for general information. If you see it, this, let's say, message in your display by Dialux. Good, so let's create empty light scenes. So we have one lighting scene, two. Let's add another one. So now we have two lighting scenes. We move on the first one. I will just, for example, click on it. I will just click on the lighting luminaires, and you see I have selected the first row, as I mentioned, and then you just need to create new luminaire group. Click on it. Yeah, the results will be invalid for the general lighting. Fine, we'll do a recalculation later on. So now we have the first, let's say, the light scene number two, which we include six luminaires. This means the first row, and let's say we will dim it to 50%, or 50. Yeah, so we go on 50%. So this one is defined. Here you just select different light scenes. So you see down is changing on the 24. Also I put here, I would go 100%. You need to click on it to be able to edit. Good, so I will go on here on fixed, and then the light scene number three. We create a new luminaire group. I will, for example, I will select the second and the first, as discussed early, and then we just create new luminaire group. And now you should see selected, we have the 12 luminaires, and here I will add on, let's say, I think it just disappeared. Yeah, this one we let it on 72%, for example. That's fine. So here you can actually add to the group or delete from the group. So here you can add more luminaires or delete a group. And here you can just dim it. Good. Now, after we have the three lighting scenes defined, I will say let's move on and do the lighting calculation. So here we have two options. In addition, I have created already an emergency a video where I detailed how you establish the emergency lighting scenes for anti-panic and also for escape room. If you did not see that video, I will add also a link below on this description. So have a look also on that one. I will not speak about the emergency lighting scene. I will just focus on the light scene, how you establish different light scenes and how you can group it and set up different light level, let's say, or dim level. And here you have two options, calculate active light scenes only or calculate all. So I will say in this case, because I want for all three, you can just active by just clicking or not clicking. I'll say we go for all. It will take a couple of seconds. And then I want to show you also how it looks in terms of lux level, but also very important is to have the render. What does it mean on how it looks? That's even more important when a single row it's working, how it's looking the space when the two rows are on 50%, for example, from the total luminous flux, and how it's looking the space when it's 100%. So good. Now we can see here the results. So on light scene number three, I will just switch on this one. We have 271 lux, and in this one we have only the first two rows. I will just go on the light scene number two, where we have a 50%. You see the lux level of 96, and then of course when we go on the light scene number one, when we dim to 50, we have half of the value. So that's a little bit getting you. And here, if I put the 100, we can calculate once again if we wanted. But yeah, that's a little bit on this setup. And now when I want to move to the 3D, I will set up the light scene number one. And when I just click on the show light textures, you'll have a good overview how the lighting is looking. And also when I add the show false colors, you have a better perception when all the lighting system is on. So now I will switch to light scene number two, when we have only the first two rows, only the first row working, sorry. So let's see the texture. So you have a perception as well of how it looks, the space illuminated only by the first row on 50%. And now moving to the light scene number three, where we have the two rows, and let's see the texture of the lighting, and the light level is on 72% from the maximum output, and you can see another perception of the space. And I will just use also the show false color. So I will say this is very important to have a look when you want to see the space illuminated only by 50%, 70%, one row for let's say switch of the luminaires for the, for example, when you have a presentation, then you go on the scene number 2, or and then all the rest of the luminaire are switched off, and the first row is only dimmed to 50%. So it's very good to know how to define different lighting scenes, especially also maybe when you have different more type of luminaires for that space, then you can use each luminaire or which type of lighting fixture on different lighting scenes, so you can create much nicer ambience, let's say, for that space. Or like in this example, you have different rows of luminaires and you don't want to let's say switch all the time. You want to have an independence of working and some flexibility of how you switch on and off, and then you can have different light scenes and see exactly what's the output and exactly of your lighting fixtures. If you have any questions, please let your comments below this video. That's all from my side. I hope that this video caught your attention. As I said, feel free to address any questions. I'm more than happy to answer to your questions. And once again, if you did not subscribe to my channel, please do so. It will help me with algorithm from my YouTube channel to promote it and more people to have access and check the videos. And yeah, I wish you all the best. Have a good day. Until next time. Bye-bye.